Ubiquiti's Wi-Fi Man Wizard has just been released out of the Early Access Store and is now generally available. So let's take a look at what this $99 Wi-Fi Man add-on can do. All right, so taking it out of the box, the Wi-Fi Man Wizard is a $99 external Bluetooth accessory for iPhone or Android. And this is a tool for doing spectrum analysis, meaning that it can read surrounding 2.4 and 5 gigahertz wireless networks. You can see the size of the thing right here. Let me put it up against like a Flipper Zero. You guys can get an idea of how small this Wi-Fi Man Wizard actually is. So the reason they came out with this device is they wanted to add spectral analysis into the Wi-Fi Man application, but Apple doesn't allow access to be able to do that natively within the iPhone. I think Android does. I'm not an Android guy, but you guys will correct me if I'm wrong. So they created this external Bluetooth accessory so that I can scan 2.4 and 5 gigahertz networks through the Wi-Fi Man app. All right, besides the Wi-Fi Man Wizard, in the box we have a quick start guide QR code. We have a case. This is a little case for the thing, like a keychain case. And then we have a charging cable, which is actually quite long. Oh man. Yeah, it's like a 6-foot charging cable this thing comes with. Okay. So the Wi-Fi Man Wizard works with the Wi-Fi Man app on iOS. It's going to be 0.18.0 or higher. And for Android, it's going to be version 1.15.0 or higher. So let me go ahead and fire up the Wi-Fi Man app. All right, so I have the Wi-Fi Man app up, and now this, I've had this Wi-Fi Man Wizard for probably 6 months or more. It's just been sitting in the box unopened. I bought it when it first came out on the EA store. So let me go ahead and plug this thing in, because it's probably gonna need some power. So on the device itself, I see a power button on the bottom as well as a little reset hole. Let's go ahead and hit the power button. Now this does have an onboard battery. There we can see the power is now blinking. And with the battery, you get about 240 minutes of continuous scanning time. Now, of course, I have not actually tested that, but that's what they claim. So new device found in Wi-Fi Man. Wi-Fi Man Wizard, we're gonna say connect. And it wants to update the Wi-Fi Man Wizard. Let's go ahead and do that. And it says estimated time remaining about 8 minutes. So I'm gonna let this do its thing and then we're gonna come back and check out how it works. Okay, I've got the Wi-Fi Wizard all set up. I even put it inside this little neoprene case here. And it didn't take very long to charge up at all, really like less than half an hour. Here we can see the scan section of Wi-Fi Man, and we have our Wi-Fi Wizard up at the top. We can see the firmware version connected. We can see the battery percentage. And then we can see our actual channel spectrum. Now it looks like in 2.4 gigahertz, my area is quite crowded. So you can select at the top 5 gigahertz or 2.4 gigahertz. And then we can see the various SSIDs, channels, and signal strength down below. Now, while you can scroll up and down through the various signal strengths and SSIDs that are detected, it doesn't allow you to sort by anything. So it'd be nice if you could like click on signal and actually sort by lowest to highest signal, something like that, or even by SSID name so that you can have like an alphabetical list if you wanted. What this does show us is the linked SSID for the Wi-Fi Man Wizard. It also shows you the channels that each SSID is broadcasting on. Plus, if you're Wi-Fi 6, there's a little Wi-Fi 6 icon next to those various networks. For instance, here we can see my T-Mobile home internet is broadcasting Wi-Fi 6 on channels 9 and 108, and it's got a really, really good signal strength of -32 dBm. And really, that's all the Wi-Fi Man Wizard does, is it gives you this ability to scan because you cannot do that in iOS natively. All right, so here's the $1 million question. Is the Wi-Fi Man Wizard worth 99 bucks in my opinion? And what I will say is if you are a standard home user that just wants to check out the signals in around your house, there's probably cheaper, better ways to do it, like just having an Android phone. But if you are a professional who does wireless installations, it is a pretty nice tool to have. Now, it's cool that it's small and compact and you can just sort of like have it in your tool bag and use it with your phone. No real extra other equipment needed, but functionality-wise, there are much better tools out there. The one that we use a lot is called NetSpot, and NetSpot allows you to not only see the signal strength of all of the various SSIDs around your location, but then you can also map points throughout a floor plan and actually get a nice sort of coverage map. Now, Ubiquiti does have that same sort of thing in WiFiMan, but it's quite lacking in that you can't really save any of the floor plan maps that you do. And on top of that, it doesn't really take into consideration upper and lower floors, like if you have a two-story house. So the WiFiMan tool is getting there, and this is a nice addition to it if you are a professional that can actually take advantage of this on a regular basis. But otherwise, I'd say save your money, just use Android, and Android has a lot of apps you can install that will do the same type of spectral analysis that the WiFiMan Wizard does for iOS. Okay, what do you guys think? Do you disagree with me? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right for you to watch next. The top video is my recent video on how to set up Cloudflare tunnels, step-by-step full instructional video, and the bottom video is my recent review of T-Mobile Home Internet.